Now, one thing, it might be a little bit different for you. Chang graphs quantity on the vertical axis and P on the horizontal axis. That's the reverse of what a lot of economics textbooks do. Actually, the way Chang does it is the proper way to do it, because quantity demanded is really the dependent variable. Price is the independent variable. And in mathematics, you graph the dependent variable on the vertical axis and the independent variable on the horizontal axis. So Chang is really doing it the way it should be done, but it's the reverse of what they often do in economics. But we'll go over that later. Let's look at this in the diagram. Graphing quantity on the vertical axis and price on the horizontal axis will look like this. Notice Q could stand for either quantity demanded or quantity supplied. Q could stand for both of those. So the demand curve looks like this. This vertical intercept might not be 100. The slope is minus 1, so it comes down like this. And where will it cross the p-axis? No, nope. Notice where it crosses the p-axis. What is quantity? At this point right here, what is quantity? Zero. Quantity is zero right here. So what kind of price would make quantity demanded equal to zero? 100, yeah, you can see it. See, if this P were 100, then quantity demanded would be zero. So sometimes that's called a chunk price, a price so high that quantity demand will be zero, so it chokes off all demand. So this horizontal intercept here would be 100. If the price ever got to 100 or higher, quantity demand would be zero. We're assuming the quantity can't take negative values. Since this is an economic problem, you really can't have negative quantities. It wouldn't make sense. So if price gets to 100 or higher, quantity demand will be zero. That's what the demand curve looks like. The supply curve looks like this. Now, one interesting feature of this supply curve, the vertical intercept is actually negative. It's minus 20. Notice that P is zero. The quantity supply would be minus 20. Now, you really can't have a negative quantity. So I'm going to draw this portion of the supply curve is a dashed line, a plus, which implies, in this case, I'm trying to imply that you really can't be in this segment. So I'll draw it as dashed. Notice the supply curve has a slope of plus 1, so eventually this curve will cross the horizontal axis. And it'll come up right here. Now, where does this supply curve cross the horizontal axis? 20. Notice that P is 20. Quantity supply would be zero. So that's really where the supply curve starts, right here. And it has a slope of plus 1. Notice the supply curve and the demand curve intersect. This is what we call the equilibrium point. Let's label this with an E, capital E for equilibrium point. And at what price do these two curves intersect? Okay, 60 for what? Oh, for price. No, I have to ask you. What price? 60. And what is the quantity corresponding to that equilibrium point? 44. That's our QCR. So if you draw a horizontal line, that's the equilibrium point. At a price of 60, the quantity that consumers want to buy, which is read off the demand curve, just equal to the quantity producers want to produce. So you have an equilibrium point. you have a balance between supply. And from now on, we will just assume that price and quantity are at equilibrium.